Have you ever looked up at a beautiful bright blue sky and asked yourself, why does it look that way? I'm Nick. Welcome to All Our Questions, where I search the internet for questions that we all want answers to, and I answer them. Today's question is, why is the sky blue? We're gonna find out, and we're starting right now. When the light from the sun hits the Earth's atmosphere, it gets scattered, bent, and reflected all over the place as it passes through gases and molecules that we have in our air. Even though the light from the sun looks white, it's actually made up of all the colors of the rainbow, and our atmosphere acts as a prism of sorts to separate the colors as they come through our atmosphere. Since blue light is a shorter wavelength, it actually gets scattered around the most, and for clarification, a wavelength is simply the distance between waves. Think of it this way. Red light is a longer wavelength, so as it comes through the atmosphere, it doesn't hit as many gases and particles. Blue, on the other hand, has a lot more waves, so it's prone to hit more particles and gases in the atmosphere. Violet actually gets scattered the most, and technically, the sky is violet. But the 6 to 7 million cones in our eyes that are responsible for color sensitivity are more sensitive to the color blue. So combined with the scattering of light, our visual system hooks us up with the beautiful blue sky that we see when we go outside on a nice sunny day, instead of a beautiful violet sky. We can still obviously see violet in rainbows and violet in the sky, but our eyes are just more sensitive to the blue light. If we didn't see the violet in the sky or indigo in the sky, then it would have more of a green tinge to it, which would probably still be really cool to look at.
Yep, sure would.
So without getting off track, if someone asks you why the sky is blue, the short answer that you can give them is, the sky is blue because of the way the light from the sun interacts with the gases and the itty-bitty particles in the Earth's atmosphere, mostly nitrogen and oxygen, and because our eyes are more sensitive to the blue color spectrum than they are to the others. But what if they say something like, all right then, smarty pants, why does it get orange or red in the morning or evening then? Well, that's easy. When the sun's going up or it's coming down on the horizon, the light has to pass through 38% more atmosphere in order to get to the same viewpoint as it would if it was coming from directly above us. Because of that, by the time the light hits us, the blue has already been scattered away to be viewed by somebody else somewhere else on the planet. This leaves our point of view with the very stunning and very romantic longer wavelength colors of red, yellow, and orange. At night, the blue, red, and every other color go away, leaving us a stunning view of the universe because we're on the dark side of the Earth and the sun's rays are no longer directly interacting with the atmosphere that we're observing. So next time you go out on a nice sunny day, you can look up at the bright blue sky and you can enjoy it just a little bit more because now you know why the sky is blue. If this video was helpful or informative in any way, give it a thumbs up. Let me know how you like to spend your bright blue sunny days down in the comments below. Make sure to connect with All Our Questions on Facebook and Twitter so you can get some other short form content. And if you're not already subscribed, I upload 2 videos every single week, so make sure to hit the subscribe button somewhere on this page so you can get more answers to all our questions. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.